Fried dough, even in the form of a puri, is so comforting just on its own. The joy of tasting a hot, crispy bende masala dosa.
Hi folks, hope you're doing well. Today we're on our way to score some hot, crisp masala dosa. Well, for those of you who've been following us, you know it's been a while since I've tasted a masala dosa on the show. I did try earlier last week to taste some masala dosa, for which I went to Taza Tindi, but they were not doing masala dosa. To know the reason, do look up the episode. I'm going to place a link right here and also in the description below. Now, when it comes to the masala dosa, people in Bengaluru have their own favorites. Of course, you get a masala dosa, a reasonably good masala dosa at every street corner, at the many darshinis, the tiny eateries that abound in Bengaluru. But then people have their iconic favorites. So for some, it's the Vidyarthi Bhavan masala dosa in Baswangudi. For others, it's the Mavaldi Tiffin Room masala dosa in Lal Bagh. And yet for others, it's the Maiya's masala dosa in Jayanagar. But today we are on our way to Maleswaram, to Sri Sagar CTR, which rules the roost for masala dosa in that part of town. We've covered CTR in an earlier episode of Gourmet on the Road, where we looked at the making of the masala dosa and some of the other dishes. If you haven't caught that episode yet, I'm going to place a link right here and also in the description below. But today we're on our way there to not just taste the masala dosa and of course one or two other popular items there, but to also see how Sri Sagar CTR is coping with things in the current situation. So stick around till the end of the episode to catch me tasting the CTR masala dosa, the bende masala dosa at CTR. We're at CTR bright and early. Table service started with standard precautions. Well, I like that poster there. Spread kindness, not germs, kindly sanitize. I think that's the order of the day. That's the need of the hour, rather. I think one should do whatever one can do to ensure that we are safe and people around us are safe. So always wear a mask, always sanitize, always wash your hands with soap, water, whenever you get an opportunity. Namaskar Sandesh, how are you doing?
Doing good, sir.
So I'm with Sandesh Pujari, who's the owner here at CTR Sri Sagar. I can see that you've changed your seating setup.
Yes, we have done a division. People are not getting any contact. Instead of four, we have made it two seating.
Okay.
One on this side, another other side. So the family section will be different, like four can sit together.
So basically, if you come as a group, you can sit here.
You can sit here.
So this is something that you've made specifically for the current situation. But you were closed for a while, were you?
We were closed for almost like 1.5 months.
1.5 months.
Yes.
You didn't want to open and take a chance.
Yes.
And even after you opened, you did deliveries. You do takeaways for most of the time.
We are doing only the takeaways and the delivery.
Okay.
Yes.
But how has business been?
It's like almost like 40%
of what you used to do earlier.
Yes.
Now earlier, I remember, of course, I've come here only in the evenings. If you come at 4 o'clock, which is when they open, at 4:05, every table is taken, every seat taken. That's how popular CTR Sri Sagar is. I'm sure the restaurant is still popular, but the current situation
has made
is what is inhibiting people from stepping outside. So, what are some of the steps that you've taken, Sandesh?
So basically, when it comes to our employees, we have been taking care of them, like medically, they have been certified. We have taken them to the hospitals. Got them thoroughly checked and made sure like they are fit and fine. And whenever they are logging in for the duties and the work, so we make sure like the temperature is checked.
Temperature.
A little above normal, we'll just send them off. Alternate days, we get the entire building sanitized.
Building sanitized, all right. And what about in the kitchen? What's happening in the kitchen? Can we take a look?
Yes, please.
Of course, that's the bende masala dosa happening. The last time we came here,
That tawa was going on full blast. I think you had about 15-16 doses. 18 doses. That's the first tawa here, the first dosa tawa here, dosa stone actually. But not bad. There were 15-18 doses going on now. Then, now there probably was 8 doses happening. Of course, that's the benne that comes from
a secret place.
From a secret place. Sandesh didn't reveal it the last time too, but it comes from a secret place, maybe some village in and around Bengaluru. Yes, yes. And that's what lends to that taste, that character, that flavor of the very famous Benne Masala Dosa here at CTR.
This is the Rava Idli.
The Rava Idli. So the signature of the Rava Idli here at CTR is the carrot. So that carrot currently is hidden.
Yes.
On the underside of this Rava Idli. When they flip it over, you will see that carrot emerge in all its glory. So I don't know how many of the dishes I will taste today. You should definitely take a look at our earlier episode on CTR as well to catch the full range of the evening tiffins. Of course, we will also taste a lot this morning as well. This is the first time that I'm at CTR on a morning. Oh, you've also changed your plates.
Yes, sir. We have started using the disposable plates.
Oh, okay. So, from a hygiene perspective.
Yes. Many of the people, like, you know, they don't like these kind of plates. They want the regular plates.
Okay. So you still have...
We still have the regular plates also, which for people customers to ask for a normal plate.
The tradition of coming to a CTR and having a Benne Masala Dosa is to have one of these trays with that banana leaf
exactly
on it, the dosa placed on it, and the chutney. Oh, there's another dosa pan happening there.
Yes, sir.
You know, I was feeling a little sad that there are only 8 dosas happening, but look at this, this is the full range here. There are 15 Benne Masala Dosa happening here. I love the Benne sizzling away on the dosa. So even the coffee now is served in disposable.
Yes.
I'm sure that every cup, a steel cup or a plate that gets used here, also gets cleaned thoroughly, sanitized thoroughly before it's presented back to the customer. So of course, if you are particular about your paper cups, you can use that, the wax paper cups. But I think the flavor of coffee is best savored in those steel tumblers, in the Dabra coffee set. Well, watching that Benne Masala Dosa sizzling away on the tawa with all that Benne and that palya has definitely got my appetite racing. So let's get to the restaurant and savor a CTR breakfast experience. Let's go. I just love the old world energy of this place. This is a building that's standing since 1952, and there's a certain charm to it. There's a certain old world charm to it. Whether it's the frames on the wall, the quaint menu board in Kannada, and of course that clock that literally takes you back in time. It's nice to see establishments paying a lot of attention to ensuring their customers are safe, whether it's in terms of the partitions. Of course, I've removed the partition from this table just so that we can shoot better. But if you look around, every table has partitions. So whether you're dining alone by yourself or you come in a group of 3 or 4, you get a table with a partition. Just to ensure that when you're eating, when you're tucking into that Benne Masala Dosa, you're eating in complete peace of mind. To the extent possible, of course. When we came here, it wasn't so busy, but we've been here 15-20 minutes and it's certainly bustling. So I think when you have great food, it's hard to keep people away beyond a certain point. Now all that we need to do is get hold of someone's attention to place our order. Namaskara. Yen ideega?
Sir, idli vada, masala dosa, set dosa, puri sagu rava idli.
So idli vade, amele puri sagu.
Sir.
Bere en try madala?
Nahi, or set dosa will be good actually.
Set dosa aadmele Benne Masala Dosa. Nime sir eno?
Basavraj.
Basavraj. Thank you. So typically the service here, at least earlier, used to be hurried. But you can still have a conversation with, because most of them have been here for years. And I've just learned that Basavraj has been here for the last 23-24 years. You know, when it comes to waiters and service staff, many a times we look at them as people that you place an order with and they go and get your food. Sure, they do all of that. But with people who've been around, with waiters who've been around at an establishment for a long time, it's nice to have a conversation, because when you have that conversation, they give you a deeper insight into not just the place, but also the sort of food the sort of dishes that you should order, which will only go to enhance your dining experience. So always be nice to the waiters. You may or may not get to meet the chef or the cook, but you will always get to meet the waiters who bring your food to you. Well, time to lower the mask and tuck into the food. The vade is warm and feels crisp to the touch. Always a good sign. I think I'm going to make a beginning with that vade, with that Uddina vade. This is the sort of vade that you want to see. Crisp, near crunchy on the outside, with this porous air pockets inside, which indicates that the batter for this vade has fermented, has risen well. Thank you. Always nice to have some extra sambar. And this vade is speckled with some chilies that make their appearance right away. Can't wait to taste this. The spicy mentioned kaim, it's erupted with its chili heat on my palate. But thankfully, there's also a sliver of coconut that I bit into. And that juiciness of the coconut, to a certain extent, tones down the aggression, the aggressive heat of that green chili. Let's go for that vade now with some of that chutney, the coconut chutney. This is a chutney that's rich in the coconut, and that's what you taste. It's got a minimal tempering of some mustard seeds, curry leaves, etc. And some green chilies as well, I'm sure that go into the spice. What you taste is a full-on creamy crunch of that coconut in that chutney. There's also a bit of heat that comes from the chilies, but it's the coconut that shines through in that chutney. Get some of that vade, this time with also a fleck of curry leaf. There's nothing as satisfying as a crisp hot vade. A vade that goes crunch, crunch, crunch to the last bite. That's what this Uddina vade is. Time now to dunk that vade into that sambar. Soak it in well, allow for the porous texture of that vade to absorb all that sambar and all its flavors. This sambar is a melange of flavors. So you have a bit of sourness that comes from the tomato, a hint of sweetness that comes from some jaggery that goes into most sambars in this part of the country, and then you also taste the goodness of the lentils. The lentils that go to fortify the sambar and lend it that body. Dunk the vade into the sambar and also get on it some of that tengin kai chutney, the coconut chutney. As you bite into that vade unburdens itself of all the flavors of that sambar. That vade soaks up the sambar and all its flavors, and when you place it on your mouth and you bite into it, it releases all the flavors of that sambar and also that tengin kai chutney. Delicious. Always nice to begin your tiffin with a idli vade. No matter what you're eating, you may be aiming for that masal dosa, you may be aiming for that set dosa, or maybe that puri sagu. Always nice though to begin with that idli vade. It's almost like a ritual for many. Well, that idli is soft. There's a hint of tartness that you taste from the fermentation in this idli. Definitely the sort of idli that will benefit from mingling with that chutney, with the tengin kai chutney. And that elevates that idli to a different level altogether. I found it a tad too tart or sour in the fermentation, but when you combine this with the chutney, it takes it in a different direction. And I think what I need to do is dunk that idli into that sambar. I lost my idli to the sambar. And the way people also enjoy the idli sambar combination is by pouring the sambar over the idli, mashing that idli into the tiniest of particles, allowing it to soak up that sambar and making for a flavorful bite, where the idli and the sambar have now become one. Also get some chutney into the mix. That tartness of that idli is now subdued subdued by the flavors of the sambar and the gentle spicy warmth of that Thengankai chutney. I love the aroma of that hot puri. It's the sort of aroma that you smell when you see puris cooking, and that's what I smell even now as this puri is on my table. Forgot to take my hat off, but you know, that's what happens sometimes when you're excited about food. I was excited about visiting CTR after a long time, you know, when they opened finally in the new normal. Ah, that wisp of hot air that escapes when you break into that puri. Fried dough, even in the form of a puri, is so comforting just on its own. But of course, out here, you savor that puri with the sagu. And this is a vegetable sagu, so it's loaded in vegetables. I can see some peas, perhaps some gourd. That's a flavorful sagu. You have the pop of the peas, the dried peas, and then the mellow bite of one of the gourds that's gone in. I don't know if it's a bottle gourd or if it's a pumpkin. I love the flavor of the sagu. The sagu is a tasty sagu. There's also some cauliflower, I think, that's gone into the sagu. Plenty of tomato and also some kai, some Thengankai. So the food served at CTR is quite South Canara in its style. And the coconut, even in sparing quantities, is a part of almost every preparation, like this tasty sagu. When you're tasting a vegetable like this sagu with the puri, because this puri is deep fried in oil, the fat from the oil goes to round off all the flavors on your palate. So just by itself, the sagu is a bit sharp. Sharp in the spices that have gone in, sharp in the tartness of the tomato. But when you cradle it in that puri and place it in your mouth, somehow that sharpness of that sagu tones down a wee bit. Some chutney. I love the thickness of that chutney. It's not a gutty chutney where it doesn't flow. It flows, but it's thick and creamy, lush with all that Thengankai, that coconut. Juxtaposed against the mild, mellow flavors of the puri, you can certainly taste the aggression of that chili in that chutney now. That chili in the chutney is bold when you taste it with the puri. So at CTR, they serve certain dishes in the morning, certain dishes in the evening. Of course, the bendne masala dosa is common in both sessions, but for some reason, I hadn't tasted the puri sagu here yet. So I said, let's taste the puri sagu while we are at it. Puri, sagu, chutney, when you think of it, seems like a rather unusual combination. But when you taste it, it somehow all seems to come together. That puri doing nothing else but cradling the flavors of both the sambar and the chutney. So you taste the savory notes of that masala in the sagu, and then you have the chutney that comes into play with its spiced coconut notes, and the puri is happy just to bring them together and round off the flavors on your palate. Get some of that curry leaf in this bite. Well, since we have two textures of dosa, the spongy set dosa and the crisp kadak bendne masala dosa, I think we should begin with that crisp dosa first, which is what we are about to do. I like the size of this dosa. In fact, the size of most of the tiffin items here at CTR are the sort that you can enjoy it and also order something else. Typically, this is served in the CTR trays, those plastic trays that are now a signature of the CTR masala dosa. But in the current situation, they have moved to these disposable Erica plates just to ensure that people are reassured when it comes to the hygiene of the patre or the plate that they're eating from. Enough said, let's get to that bendne masala dosa. Bendne masala dosa is so crisp that you can lift it entirely on its own without the dosa sagging even the least. So you have this crisp kadak dosa that's twirled around that creamy soft aloo gadde palya. You can see all that benne, all that butter glisten away on the dosa, and as you break into it, all that butter, all that benne also clambers onto your fingers. The joy of tasting a hot, crispy benne masala dosa. I love the texture of this dosa. So it's crisp on the outside, and on the inside, as the dosa maker ladles the batter on the tawa, you have the thick parts which are soft, crispy on the outside but soft inside, and then you have the thin parts which are almost paper crisp. And that's what makes that benne masala dosa supremely interesting texture-wise. I love the creamy goodness of that aloo gadde palya. That palya is almost mousse-like. In the dosa today, I'm also detecting a slight hint of sweetness. I'm not sure if that comes from the potatoes or the sweetness of the onions. I'm going to savour that masala dosa now with the chutney. The buttery notes, the benne in this benne masala dosa has completely calmed the spicy note of that coconut chutney. When it comes to flavors, fats rule. So the dosa is served with two chutneys. One is of course the coconut chutney, and then you have that coriander chutney. That coriander mint chutney. You can definitely taste that refreshing zing of that coriander and also the mint in that chutney. That benne masala dosa is crunchy, crispy, soft and butter laden from the first bite to the last. And as and when you think the butter is getting to you, dunk the dosa in some of that chutney. To reset your palate and dive back into the creamy butter-laden flavors of this benne masala dosa. Time to shift gears and go for that set dosa. Of course, the set dosa has cooled down a wee bit while we were tucking into that benne masala dosa. But since this is a soft, spongy dosa, I don't see any problems on that count. I love the spongy, lacy texture of this dosa. Because when it comes to the benne masala dosa, it's full-on indulgence. The set dosa is more austere in flavor. Of course, there's none of the benne, and there's very little oil as well that you see either on the surface of this dosa or even when you break into it. So the dosa almost feels dry, and you definitely want to soak this dosa into the sagu. And then the set dosa sings the flavors of the spices in the sagu. So this is my fourth dish here at CTR on this outing. Around me I can hear people order. First on the vade kodi, amele on the rave idli kodi, amele benne masala kodi. So basically this is a place where you come and you order at least two or three dishes, because the size of the portion is such that it's quite manageable. And of course, when it comes to the flavors, each of the different treats here are enjoyable in their own way. So the set dosa is always served in a set of three. Of course, out here it's a compact set of three. So if you want to eat a dosa which is not heavy on the butter or the ghee, definitely go for the set dosa. I love the manner in which this dosa absorbs the curry, absorbs the sagu, almost like a sponge, true to its name. And when you place it in your mouth, it spews forth the flavor of that sagu in a stream of deliciousness. That thick, creamy coconut chutney is delicious enough to be savored on its own, with that garni of mustard seeds and curry leaves. Thank you. truth be told, I'm quite sated after eating the idli vade, the puri sagu, the bende masala dosa, and that set dosa. And I was just about to order for the coffee when I suddenly remembered that I enjoyed my tasting of the kesari bath the last time around. So I said, let me order for it and just have a bit of it, just to rekindle old memories. This is a kesari bath that's lush in the ghee, and you can see that glisten in that kesari bath, and also the ghee on that banana leaf. Of course, there's all that ghee and the flavor of the clove that you taste, but I love that slight stickiness, that slight untu, as they say locally in Kannada, character of that kesari bath. You know, when it comes to the kesari bath, the recipe is fairly simple. Everybody uses the same ingredients. Whether it's a semolina, in some places they also use a combination of the vermicelli. And then of course you have copious amounts of ghee, a hint of saffron, some godambi, the cashew, raisins, and some places they also use the fruit. Some places they use the pineapple. The other day I tasted one which had some jackfruit. But each kesari bath, although it follows a very similar recipe, has its own character. And out here is that lush, ghee-laden butteriness of that kesari bath and that untu, that slight sticky character when you place it in your mouth. The way it gathers itself together, it's almost toffee-like texture. These days they're serving the coffee in the waxed paper cups, but for me, the joy of drinking a coffee in a traditional tumbler set is quite something else. That sip of piping hot filter coffee, strong, slightly bitter, with a hint of sugar, at the end of an extended tiffin session, leaves one completely satisfied. The establishment's doing a fair bit to ensure that they are safe, the customers are safe, with all the measures that they've taken, right from temperature checks to sanitization to glass partitions in between table, etc. Notwithstanding the current crisis, it's nice to find moments like this just to take us back to the memories of some good old times. Currently, we're all worried for ourselves, for people around us. But then at some point, like they say, this too shall pass. I'm an optimist, and I like to believe that no matter how dark things may seem now, no matter how gloomy the situation may be now, this too shall pass. Maybe a few months, maybe a little longer than that. But until then, I believe it's important to every once in a while get away from all that doom and gloom to a place like this, where you can not only indulge in some delicious tiffin treats, but also savor the memories of the good old days. I say the good old days, but I'm confident that those good old days will return for sure someday. Until the next time, stay safe, stay very, very safe, and happy eating.
If you'd like to support the work that we do at Food Lovers TV, do consider joining our membership community on YouTube by hitting the join button below or on the homepage. You could pledge a nominal sum and receive special privileges like behind-the-scenes footage, shoot updates, access to live Q&As, and a lot more. You could support us on a Patreon page as well. For more info, check out the links in the description below. If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe, like, share, and leave a comment below. Happy eating!